Hi, everyone, and welcome to today's discussion on AI amplification of the human potential. I'm Ronald van Loon, and joining me today is Pascal Bonnet. He's the award-winning expert in AI and automation, and he's the author of the best-selling book, Intelligent Automation. Welcome, Pascal, and it's really great to have you on our series.
Thank you.
Today, we're going to explore how AI is not just about technology, it's about enhancing our human capabilities. And this topic is crucial because as we advance technologically, it's essential to understand how we can leverage AI to amplify our potential rather than just replacing it. And I'd like to start with some bold statements. And Pascal, you've written the book, The Intelligent Automation. And what, from all the statements that you make in your book, is really standing out? And can you describe what we can expect in the coming years from AI developments? What's the key statement that you made in your book?
Ronald, thanks for asking this. And I like those thought-provoking statements. So I did many of them in Intelligent Automation, the book that I released 4 years ago, but also in Irreplaceable, the book that will be released in a few months. One of the ones that I prefer is the most important in AI is people. That's based on my 20 years of experience implementing AI systems around the world. And I think I will explain it to you later on. The second one is to excel in a future with artificial intelligence, one doesn't need to build specifically technological or technical skills. And the third one is AI pushes us to be more human. So I would be delighted to go into more explanation around this.
Yeah, and I have some statements as well. One is a very nice statement, I think, from the CEO from Infosys, Salil Parekh, and he had a webcast at I think a few weeks ago, and he emphasizes that at Infosys, out of 8 people from Infosys employees, they're being trained on generative AI and other AI technologies, of course, as well. And as you mentioned as well, it's very important to focus on your people. And I think this reflects as well the importance of integrating AI deeply within your organization, but also with, let's say, seeing the importance of the employees. And with Infosys, they increase even in employees, so it's not replacing people. And I think this also highlights you get most out of the human capital if you invest in the combination. I have some other ones. I spoke recently with the CEO from Google DeepMind, which is their Google lab, and he predicted that AI can increase productivity by a factor 10 in the coming 5 years. I was a little bit shocked when I heard this, but if we dive deeper into it, I think we can all see that is really, really the case. And as we are both content creators, it's even stated that 90% of the content will be created already in 2025 by AI. So for us, a lot of things are going to change. So what we see, I think, is that the highest value lies in the intersection of AI and the human capabilities, where AI pushes us, as you mentioned already, to be more human. So let's double down on the AI adoption to make our world basically more human. But now, as you mentioned already, let's explore more why our bold statements about AI and human potential are really realistic scenarios. And let's start with basically the thoughts about AI success depends on people, as you mentioned, where we look at the AI human, the AI human collaboration, where data and knowledge are generated by the people. This data is used in AI models, but what we see is that the models develop very, very fast, and the competition is increasing as well. For example, if you look to the LLM models, and the data and the knowledge is the foundation, and the models are just, if you look at it, more temporary because they are improved all the time and they will be updated very fast. Now, can you elaborate on your statement where you talked about AI success really depends on the people with the value of this AI human collaboration? Let's go in more detail.
Yes, with pleasure, Ronald. And I fully share what you just mentioned. So the first one, the most important in AI is people. This is coming from my 20 years of experience at EY and McKinsey, where I implemented artificial intelligence systems around the world for corporate clients. The only projects that I've seen really succeed are those ones that were placing the people in the middle. So the most critical in the sense of informing, educating, empowering the people to use this technology. The most critical for the success of AI is not sophisticated algorithms for me, but it's really about people. And I've been able to experience it during this experience. What I like to say is that AI is built by people for people. So basically, we might have the most sophisticated AI, but if it is not useful to humans, that's just a waste. So I'm completely aligned with you with the sentence that the highest value lies at the intersection between AI and human. And this is really where I focus my research, and I focus the book, Irreplaceable Content, is really around this. The second key bold statement that I shared with you is that to excel in the future with AI, one doesn't need to build technological or technical skills. Very often we think, we need to know how to program or to code to succeed in the future with AI. But as we've seen, generative AI is able to code and to code even better than us. So what does it mean? It means that to create the highest value with AI, we need to create synergies with AI. And the way to create synergies is to complement AI, in the sense that we create skills that AI, that are the most different from what AI can do. And what are those skills? Those skills are basically those that make us human, okay? Basically our human abilities. And how do we know what are our human abilities? These are the abilities that we have when we are born. And very easy to find them. You go to the playground and you see kids playing together. You'll see that they are building a castle, okay, or imagining stories. So basically, creativity is a key one. The second one is critical thinking. So they will question, the rules of the game, for example, and they will say, this should be the rules, you should not be this one. So critical thinking is the second one. And the third one is relationship. So basically, whenever you have a new kid coming into the playground, the others will just bring him and ask him to join the game. So those are the three key skills that are purely humans, in the sense that only humans with authenticity can produce them. And artificial intelligence, while it can mimic them, will always lack the authenticity of our emotions, of our life stories, of our personalities. So that's the second bold point. And the third one, remember, was AI pushes us to be more human for two reasons. For the first reason we just discussed about it. The future is not about learning how to code or program, even though it's useful. Don't get me there. But about learning and developing to a new level those human abilities. So that's one reason. The second reason is AI helps us to move away from those transactional repetitive activities. You know, those activities that are mundane, that are about copying data, about sending emails, about managing reports, those activities that no one likes to do, that are not human, I would say, okay? So that's how AI pushes us to be more human.
Yeah, I totally agree on that, where AI will amplify the potential basically of every human. And on one end, by automating this repetitive task, and on the other hand, it frees the focus for us human more on the creative part, the strategic part, but also the empathetic part. And these are qualities which you mentioned already. You mentioned already the different ones, but which are really inherent to the humans. And I think this transformation achieves us to greater productivity, also to greater examples. To greater innovations. So, for example, if we look to Infosys and other organizations, they use already these AI assistants for many different roles. You were talking about developers, where the question is, okay, how much a developer still needs to develop or need to think about the architecture, need to think about the type of solutions. If you look to support engineers, what will be their role? Is it more the creative part, or is it doing the repetitive task? It will be more the creative part, and supporting users for solving all complex problems. The same with salespeople, where you don't have to do all the repetitive task of outreach, but you can really talk to people and go in depth and understand their situation. So I think we get to the core here, but in the end, if we combine it, then yeah, we really can be more productive if we combine the human and the AI capabilities.
Exactly. Ronald, let allow me one point here. So I'm completely aligned with what you said. So those technical skills that AI can now manage better than we do and will be able to manage even better in the future are important. We need to know about them. We need to have this literacy. But where we will bring the value will be through those purely human abilities that we talked about. And hence, we will create a complementarity, a synergy with AI that will create more value as a whole. So what does it mean for companies? You just gave great examples. I'm looking a little bit further in time and thinking of, in the future, all companies will be using AI. And we all agree that AI is like electricity. It's going to be a kind of a commodity that everybody will be using. So in the future, those companies that will succeed will not be the ones that will be using AI, because everybody will be using AI. But the ones that will succeed will be the ones that will be able to combine strategically AI with human capabilities. And I really believe that this is where companies will be able to create differentiation. I like to talk about, and I talk about it in the book Irreplaceable, the principle of value and innovation. So basically, anytime you have a task, an activity that relates to your strategic goals as a company, to your competitive advantage, or that specifically requires nuanced human judgment, this activity should be done by human. All the other activities could be automated.